reporter, Linda Sinclair. And Linda, I think everyone is always fascinated by the numbers. They're about to get worse. What's the wider picture?
Well, we've just been listening to the Prime Minister, Boris Johnson, giving his daily news briefing. He started by saying the NHS, like other health services, only has a limited amount of equipment, so it's vital to delay the spread of the virus. The PM also thanked everyone who has been following the clear rules set out on Monday. That's the lockdown, along with frontline NHS staff and public services. He also praised the 400,000 people who volunteered to help the NHS. And the UK government's chief medical officer, Professor Chris Whitty, when asked about the rate of testing in the UK, said testing of people to determine whether they have the virus is being ramped up. And he says an antibody test to see whether people have had it is quite close, but has not yet finished being evaluated. Now in Scotland, six more deaths have been announced from the virus, taking the total number to 22. And there are now 719 confirmed cases of the virus here, a rise of 135 in the last 24 hours. Across the UK as a whole, there are now 437 deaths. And we found out the families of health workers will be prioritised for testing so key staff can get back to work quicker and not put any extra burden on the NHS. More widely, a quarter of the world's population is now living under some form of lockdown. The death toll in Spain has now overtaken China, rising by 738 to 3,434. Slightly more positive news in Italy, John, where the death rate has actually slowed. We reported another 683 deaths in the last 24 hours. That's a slight fall from Tuesday's 743 deaths.
Yeah, Linda, thank you. It's extraordinary, isn't it, when we start talking about that volume of deaths and a marginal decrease in the rate of increase. Amazing. It appears there's a global shortage, isn't there, of testing kits. Now, parting is such sweet sorrow, Juliet's words to Romeo. And it could have been written about this coronavirus lockdown, couldn't it? Social distancing and social isolation is certainly putting love and the young to the test. Now, couples who don't live in the same households have been asked to stay apart and not see each other until the crisis is over. Earlier, I caught up with 20-year-old Ali and 18-year-old Niamh, who've been going out together for 6 months.
There's FaceTime and stuff nowadays, so you can still technically see each other, but it's quite weird not seeing her in person every day that you're used to. Like, also, there's no, like, cuddling and kissing and stuff, so that's...
So Niamh, now, your world's changed, hasn't it? Because, you know, I was young once, and there's a lot of kissing and cuddling going on, but not now.
No, nothing. Sometimes we take that for granted, so now that we don't have that, it's weird. It's weird, like, not seeing, like, kind of every day, you know, like, hugging and kissing and stuff, so yeah.
Ali, then, when was the last time you saw each other?
It was probably last Monday, just before the college got shut down. I'd say that, I think that's about right, isn't it?
Yeah, about a week, so yeah. I
feel
like really long.
Yeah.
Does it?
Yeah, because obviously, like, we're in college basically every single day, so I see her every single day, and then suddenly,
yeah,
not seeing her at all, it's quite...
Yeah, and also, like, socialising
at
the weekend as well, so it's also letting
talk of
that as well, so not having that is really difficult as well.
There's a bigger question there, isn't there? So you first then, Ali. How has life changed for youngsters? There was school, there was college, there were parties, there was all manner of funny games, and the world kind of stops.
You never really realise how much you're used to going out until it suddenly just stops, and then you're like, what am I?